My name is James K. Polk. I am a private investigator. The first case that started it all was the murder of Jimothee C. by his sister Penny C. My last case, I was undercover as a figure named Dan with a group of hooligans who wished to murder Penny. The hooligans in question were named Samantha, Brittany, Richard, and an unnamed assailant. And while I was undercover, I realized that they had murdered Penny C in cold blood. It was strictly business. However, I did end up forming a friendship with this group of hooligans, and I did in fact bail them out of jail because of their murder of Penny C. The case I just got was the murder of Samantha by poison. Samantha? There can only be four people who have done this. Question mark. Richard? Chad the Rizzard? Or Brittany? Who could have poisoned that bagel?
Wow, guys, it's crazy. I mean, this is just like being in jail. It's weird.
I don't think we've met before, young man. I'm Richard Johnson. Call me Dick. Are you a UPS driver? I feel like I've seen you around before.
Must have been in the wrong place at the wrong time or something.
Nice job, young man. Golly. Good stuff. Huh? Next time you're in too.
What is your relationship to Samantha?
Bro, why are you asking me, bro? This is a comfortable prison, bro. Golly.
Are you comfortable?
Yeah.
What is your alibi during the murder of Samantha?
I don't know, man. I don't even know who that is, bruh. You tripping.
Fascinating. What is your relationship to Samantha?
Fire!
What is your alibi? What is your relationship to Samantha?
She was dating my best friend like a while ago, but he kind of died, and so now we're like friends, I guess.
Well, what's your alibi to this, Samantha?
I was at Starbucks because I really, really wanted a pink drink, and so I got one, and it was really, really good. So I couldn't have been me. I was nowhere near.
What is your relationship to Samantha?
She's my dead cousin's girlfriend.
Interesting. Where were you at the time of the incident?
I was robbing three banks across the tri-state area.
What a good boy. Clear. You know, amidst all the pressures and tough parts of the our lives lately, I just wanted to have dinner once again as friends. You know, there's something about this dinner. I'm still trying to figure out who actually did this case or did this murder. You know, I really think it's that guy, that tall guy who sits across from me. I don't like him.
Are we splitting this tab or paying separately?
I don't know.
I sure do love watching the newest Mr. Beast videos when they come out. I sure do hope I can pay with my credit card.
I think it's important that we have a moment of silence for this. Samantha's loss is very tragic, and I think it's a point that we respect that.
This dinner's been like kind of weird, but I have to say, I didn't really like Samantha all that much, and you know, whoever killed her must be like really good at it because we have no idea who it was, right? So like, they're kind of a genius, I have to say.
Bro, put your hand down, man. Honestly, you just a bagel man. Why are you even here? This is a Mr. Beast video?
Yeah, what do you think this is? Like, us to take their hand off of the table, like, wins $5,000? Like, what are you even doing here?
Bro, even so, you already lost. You already lost. No $500,000 for you, bro. Oh my god, man.
La cena fue horrible. Él con el pelo castaño lo odio, es tan estúpido, lo quiero matar. Señora, no sé lo que está diciendo, me gustaría aclarar.
You know, about this dinner, you know, I was roasting that bagel guy over there, you know, he looks like he really likes to watch Mr. Beast videos, but like, to be honest, I don't even know why I'm here either. Yeah, I have nothing to do with this. You need to go back to play Clash Royale, bruh.
What did you guys think of prison first time?
It sure was terrible. I wasn't able to mow my lawn for 3 weeks.
It's pretty comfortable.
I thought it was gross.
I think you should watch your tone, lady.
I think you should shut up, actually. What are you laughing about? Jail isn't funny. You didn't even have to go.
It's true. I did bail all of you guys out. The unnamed assailant hypothesis fell through. The unnamed assailant was murdered brutally by a vehicle. And there's still evidence for each person at the crime scene. For example, this blood is the blood of Samantha. But that's odd because Samantha died a long time ago. My primary suspect right now is Richard. The vehicle used as the murder weapon of the unnamed assailant was used by Richard. Which is why I believe it's Richard. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. Richard was pushed off of a building, and evidence points to other people once again. The unknown assailant's hair was found at the crime scene. That doesn't make any sense because he's dead. This footprint only matches with one other person, and that is the UPS driver, Chad Rizzard. This makes Chad Rizzard my primary suspect. My Mr. Rizzard hypothesis has fallen through as he was brutally murdered. However, this was found at the crime scene. Shipped to Chad Rizzard, 1876 Rainbow Road, Rizztown, Arizona, 7769. The return address is 1234 You Wish You Knew Drive, Takeover Town, Evil Lair, Badville, 321. With bag. Right here. See it.
Mm-hmm.
All the evidence only seems to point to one person. And that person is Brit.
Are you recording? You better be recording. I'm going to tell you exactly. 3 years ago, I was hired by the British Mafia to take out Jimothee C. because he owed the British Mafia a lot of money. And when I say a lot of money, I mean a lot of money. So I came over here to America to, you know, come take him out because I'm a hitman and I'm pretty cool. I went and I visited Jimmy to get the money I needed for the British Mafia. And he couldn't pay me back because he was in a lot of debt. So I decided I was going to get somebody else to do the dirty work for me because I was feeling kind of lazy. So, I was the one who killed Nemo, Penny's fish, and I framed Jimmy so she would kill Jimmy for me because she's kind of crazy, let's be honest. After Penny was caught, I decided to visit her in jail to get my money that I still needed, and that poor little broke girl couldn't pay me. So I did what I had to do, and I got her cousin, stupid little American mafia member, to bail her out of jail for me so I could take her out. I framed the kidnapping of all the pets on her. I kidnapped them and planted them in her house, so all the members of that hooligan squad, as James likes to call them, would take them out. I was having some fun, I'll be honest. And I decided to join in and kill Penny with them. And that's how I ended up in jail. However, I did become buddy-buddy with James, who was undercover at the time as Dan, so I could get out of jail. And I convinced him to bail us all out. After we got out of jail, I still needed my money, so I went to Samantha, his girlfriend. And she couldn't pay me either, so I had to take her out. I gave her a poison bagel. It was pretty easy. I planted some evidence, made sure the trail led to someone other than me, you know, the unnamed guy whom honestly nobody even knows. But it wasn't enough money, sadly. After I took her belongings, I still didn't have enough, so I had to take out that other guy too, and I framed Richard, the idiot. But I still didn't have enough money, so I had to take out Richard too. Unfortunately, everything was going great, and I would have had the right amount of money if it weren't for the stupid little UPS driver, Chad Rizzo, whatever his stupid name is. So naturally, I had to take him out too. I planted the bomb. I killed Chad. I had to take out the idiot private investigator James, because he learned too much. Just like I'm going to have to take out you. See, you know too much, but I'm going to use this video you filmed for me, for the British Mafia, as proof of what I did. Say bye-bye!